Hello again and welcome back to The Long Dark, Season 8. And when we last left off, we had gotten into the farmhouse, which was decidedly a good thing. We didn't find all that much clothing, but we did find some, so that was good. And now we've pretty much gone through the whole house. But unfortunately, didn't find all that we were looking for. One of the things that's concerning right now is that we don't have very many tools. We don't have very many tools. We've got a hacksaw. And that's pretty much it, so... Oops. Forgot the file cabinets. I knew we forgot something in here.
This stuff will come in handy.
And it sounds very stormy outside. So, I think we may just want to... stay in here. For today. Okay, so, like we usually do, let me sneak in here and check some stuff. Okay. There's some wool socks right there. They're not in great shape, but they'll do. Like we normally do, let's stock a, stock a fridge and a freezer. First of all, let's take a look at what we've got. We are a little bit thirsty, so that is a concern. So let's drink what we've got so far. Okay, we definitely don't need to be carrying around all of this food, and we've got a ton of cans. Which is really kind of unfortunate because we don't have a can opener, or really anything that serves as a can opener. Maybe we can open these things with the hacksaw. But for right now, let's put that stuff away. Did find the fire striker and the magnifying glass, which is really good. This fire striker's in bad shape, though. So that will only be for, real, you know, dire circumstances here. Okay, so here's the stove, so let's put into this cabinet right here all of our wood stuff. We're going to keep the cedar firewood with us. Okay, well, first of all, we don't need 8 books, so let's transfer all of those. There we go, that's 8 pounds off. I think we can pretty much keep the rest of this with us. Over in this cabinet, I think we're going to keep our tool, our supply stuff. So here's all our cloth. Scrap metal. And the cured leather. The rest of this can pretty much stay, I think. Let's put in 2 things in newsprint. Here's our tools. I'm gonna put one of this. Okay, so let's come back over here. And we'll go into here, and this is going to be our wardrobe. So every piece of clothing that we're not wearing right now goes into here. Socks, the work boots. Okay. So now, we're in pretty good shape. So let's just gonna look around and make sure that we got everything. Alright, let's step out onto the porch for just a little bit, because the porch should protect us from the wind, and there might actually be a little bit of stuff out here. Okay, yes, it is very windy and snowy and everything else out there. So we definitely don't want to go out there. It's probably a little... Oh no, it's still okay out here. So, let's check the metal container. And nothing. Okay. Broken panes of glass here, so just wondering if stuff comes through here or not. So we've pretty much finished off the looking around the entire farmhouse. We did go down into the the basement too. Okay, so that's that. We can break down the... Oh, we need a pillow to break down the hunting knife. Do we need a hatchet to break down the table? Okay. So, let's get rid of the chairs that are broken and fallen, because we can't put them back up again. Down the toaster. Okay, our caloric count is a little low right now. So we're both hungry and thirsty. So let's try this out. Let's see if... No, we cannot use the hacksaw to open up cans of pork and beans, so let's just smash it open. It's at 39% anyway, so... It's not the best, so let's drink some soda. Let's check where we're at. Oh, we could drink another soda if we want to. So let's do that. Okay, let's check again. That's pretty good. So, okay. Start a fire and make some more water and store it here. Just not a totally bad idea. We'll use some of this reclaimed wood. We could also sleep a little bit too. We are kind of. decided rather stay on the, you know, do stuff during the day and sleep at night schedule. Sounds like all right, and then we're just going to melt as much snow as we possibly can. Okay. All right, we're going to come around here, and okay. So the unsafe water goes up in the freezer. The safe water goes in here. Okay. Now we're probably hungry and thirsty again. So let's... drink the soda. We'll eat the candy bar. And then we'll drink some of the water. Okay, at this point, we have 2 hours of daylight left. Gonna do it 2 hours of daylight. We have no weapons to speak of. Well, I don't really want to go out exploring because I only have 2 hours of daylight left. I'm gonna have very little. There's a storm lantern. There's a sewing kit. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do for the rest of my time here. There's a toque, and there's some basic gloves. This is the importance of lighting areas up. Okay, so we're gonna come up here. Let's go into the master bedroom. Checked all the drawers and everything, right? Okay. And the cabinets and the drawers, yep. Okay, so let's... actually, we're gonna head downstairs. We've got the sewing kit. Let's do some sewing until we are tired. So let's head back over and I think it was this one. Yep, there we go. Transfer all. We'll even transfer that one over too. So let's take a look in our inventory. We need to repair a lot of stuff. We need to repair these. Okay, now that I have enough materials, it's only 1 hour of daylight left, so let's head up to the bedroom. Okay. All right, That's actually looking a lot better. I think we could do that again, though. Okay, now they're at 89. Can we repair these? Yes, we can. Alright. Those are at 82. That's good. 95 is pretty good. I'm not too worried about that. 93 is pretty good there. I'm not too worried about that either. Oh, hey, look, I have a hat. So let's wear the hat. And we'll also repair the hat, too. Perfect. 65, 88. These are the only other ones. Repair those. They should probably repair them to full or close to it. Okay. There we go. That's our extra gloves, but we'll put them away next time. And I think it's time to sleep. Wait a minute. Before we do that, let's eat and drink a little bit. Because if you look, yeah, we're... So, I'm going to eat these. And, you know what? We'll drink one of these. Okay, let's take a look at where we're at. That's pretty good. So let's sleep for 8 hours. Sounds like the wind's picking up a little bit. And now it sounds like it's storming. Okay, less than 1 hour darkness left. So, let's drink. For 1 more hour, just so that we have, you know, dawn. Okay. It sounds pretty good. I don't hear any wind. Oh, I spoke too soon. Let's come down here, and let's bust into the fridge for a little bit. Let's take out the worst stuff. Because that's essentially the stuff that's going to go bad first. Alright. Next, I want to come into the closet over here. Basic gloves. Okay. Alrighty, ...13 hours of daylight left. We're kinda hungry. It sounds really, really windy out there. Well, let's take a peek at what the weather looks like out there. The nice part about the farmhouse is that you actually have an opportunity to do this. Basically, go out onto the porch and see what it looks like. It actually looks pretty good out there. Now, I think it's going to be cold. Like we usually do. see, it's freezing out here. It's just funky textures. Anyway, so here's our new home. Ta-da! Here's the orchard. Let's check out the car. Just for a moment. Okay. Checking the glove box, nothing. Pull down the visors. Check the radio. You know, one of these days when I check the radio, it's actually going to work, and I'm going to probably jump out of my seat. That would be really funny. But, according to the story, the radio should never work. Okay, there's a wolf way over there. But... bunnies in this orchard. Not sure exactly where to go right now. I don't think I should go anywhere right now because it is very cold out here. To the point where I almost lost all of my heat, I think. Yeah, so... we need to be homebodies for just a little while longer. And then I think we can go out. So all of this stuff can break down, huh? Let's see, what else can we do? Let's break down a crate or two. There's a ton of stuff that could be broken down in here. Sounds like the wind is whipping up again, too. Alright, we are cold and we are hungry. Could get a little fire started. Some reclaimed wood. And that way we can bust open a can of pork and beans. And then heat the pork and beans and eat the pork and beans. And then, once we do that, once we do that, then we'll have at least a little bit of protection from the cold for a little bit. We may try to head out towards either Three Strikes or the Radio Tower. The Radio Tower, I think, is going to be hard because, you know, we don't really have any good protection against wolves. We have one flare, and that's it. go back into here. And we'll eat this. Alright. And then back in here, do the same thing again. To this can of pork and beans. Drink a hot cup of coffee. Okay. This. And then for the rest of this, we're just going to melt some stuff. And whatever snow we can melt, that's what we got. Whoops. Safe water supply. Okay, we go into the fridge. We are running out of food, so we're gonna need to go someplace. 10 hours of daylight left. Three Strikes Farm doesn't really have any buildings that will protect us. So, I think maybe we should try to head for the radio tower. The radio tower is out this way. I'm probably gonna pick up some hypothermia doing this, but that may, in fact, be the least of our worries. Because chances are we're going to pick up some dog bites on the way. Or bear bites or something. Okay. So, let's check the mailbox, just in case if somebody happened to have snuck a candy bar in there or something. Okay, now it's up in 10 minutes. Now, I have no idea if flares scare off bears. Something tells me they don't. I don't really know if that's true or not, but I think I tried it once before, and it does not. So the key is, if you run into the bear, just run. Now, there is a cave over here, as I recall. This hill. We're going to be very tired by the time we hit the radio tower. But it's quite cold. Well, at least the rock wall is protecting us from the cold. Which is decidedly a good thing. Still too cold, though. Okay. We'll catch our breath for a little bit. In preparation to run up that hill. Up there, but that doesn't mean that none's up there. There's a bear that chills out up here every once in a while. Considering the lack of bears that I've seen around the area, I'm willing to bet that he's probably hanging out around here. Which is kind of unfortunate for me. Rainier Tower hopefully is going to have other stuff in it. Goodies. Okay, there's the farm. The barn and stuff. If I come up here... Hello, radio tower. It's a radio control hut. Okay, we made it. And there's
a can opener.
Yay! And more canned stuff. Salty crackers. We like salty crackers. Pinnacle peaches. A bucket of water. Bandage. This is all good stuff. Here's the microwave. Nothing in the microwave, but there's something next to it. It is yet another fire striker. I have to say, for... Oh, and a pair of cargo pants. This has been a great... A great find. Okay, metal shelf. Two lockers that don't require pry bars. Oh, look, it's a scarf. And a pair of jeans. Excellent, excellent stuff. Thin wool sweater. Hmm. Another sewing kit.
Okay.
Alright. Now, I should say there is something to be said for lighting a match around here. Because then you, find the hunting rifle and the bullets that somebody left here for you. No, it's okay, I don't want to break that down. And the mariner's peacoat. See, now we're in good shape.
Never know. Could end up being useful.
And another storm lantern. See, this is why you light matches. There's a pair of boots over here. Down there. Right. Oh, somewhere around here. Well, where is it? Oh, there's a sewing kit right there. Metal shelf. Where is the bullet? There it is. Okay, so... And that locker's locked. Gosh darn it, that's unfortunate. You know, once we find a pry bar, we're going to have to go back to all the places we've been to. There's a book. Let's check the drawers. Well, so far, this has been a fantastic places to go. We found food. We found better clothing. We found a weapon. I still don't have a knife, which is kind of... oh, I would say a little frustrating. There's a piece of reclaimed wood. The problem with the radio control tower is that there's no place to start a fire in here. It is almost, and I say almost as good as the farmhouse. Okay, so let's take a look at what we got. There's a lot of food that is really crappy, so let's just eat it all. We're going to use the can opener for that. Okay. Checking out our clothing. We should wear that. We should definitely wear that. We should definitely wear that. And then we should probably repair some of this stuff, too. How are we doing on time? We've got 8 hours of daylight left. Which means we can go back down the hill if we need to. We're still cold, though, so we need a little bit of time to warm up. So while we're doing that, let's repair some clothing. That is a lot better. And let's repair this. Okay, we got 6 hours of daylight left. Okay, the gun is actually in good shape. We have 6 bullets for it. We found another fire striker that's actually in pretty good shape. Our food supply is now okay. Let's take care of the rest of that can. Let's drink some water. Just trying to get the weight down right now. What are we getting weighed down by? All of the clothing that we're carrying? Some other stuff that we're carrying. We're carrying 2 lanterns. But yeah, so we have how many hours left now? 5 hours of daylight left, and we're getting tired. Okay. So let's, go out the door. Let's load our rifle. Okay, feeling a lot better about this now. I know I probably probably do this every single time, but can we actually get down this way? I don't think so. While we're here, let's pick some rose hips. Now, just for the fun of it, it is a one arrow now. We're actually in better... This is stalker mode where, you know, they could line up 40 bears in a row. And it would just happen to be your bad luck. As we've learned before, two wolves can pretty much show up in the same location at the same time. As good at aiming the rifle as I am, which is pretty horrible. You kind of get in trouble, so... Trudging through the snow. There's the cave. It's good to know where that is, because if we happen to run into a situation where we need to duck into the cave between going between the two areas, we can. Although there isn't really much... There's not really much, much better stuff in the radio control tower as there is in the farmhouse, which is kind of why I like the farmhouse a little bit better. We are going to need to start hunting pretty soon, though. We've got 6 bullets. Is not going to, it's not going to last for very long, so we're also going to need to look to make bow stuff, although my bow shot is even more horrible than, my rifle. Getting a little tired, but that's okay. We'll head back to the house. Take stock of all of our stuff, and probably head to sleep, and then that'll be the end of this video. Sneak in here. Let's close the door. Go through the door. Okay, the plan is to get rid of some of this extra clothing. So let's do that. Now, eventually, we're going to want to have a secondary outfit that that we do stuff in. And then we'll probably break down the rest of the stuff. If we have to move locations, thankfully we don't have that much stuff. So let's put the gun away for now. Let's head back up here. We'll eat and drink a little bit of food. And then go to sleep. So let's do that. Yeah, we're pretty tired. Well, we actually have a decent amount of food that we have, so let's eat some of the crackers. Because we've got water, so. Okay. And then we're going to sleep for 8 hours. We'll wake up, eat and drink, sleep for another like 4 or 5 hours, and then it'll be the end of this video. So, let's eat. That'll be enough. And let's drink. Okay, sleep for another, 6 hours or something. Make it 8 hours. Okay, and then we're gonna stop right here. Very, very good episode here. We got a lot of good stuff, and we are fixing to be in a good spot here. So anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you've had fun, and I will see you in the next video.